Welcome all, we are going to start our 20th lesson, that is in the world of stars. So what is galaxy? What are the various components of galaxy? Basically in 6th standard we already went through this verse. So actually what is galaxy? So galaxy is that part of our universe which consists of all heavenly bodies. There are planetary systems, there are stars, there are asteroids and various things. So what are the different types of the stars? Last year we have studied about, when you were in 6th standard, you have already studied about the different types of stars. Red giant star, sun-like stars, then supernova star, variable star, binary or twin star. So we have already learned about the galaxies and stars as well as the solar system and its different components. Stars are born out of the nebula. Nebula are the clouds made up of mainly hydrogen gas and the dust particles. So basically this all solar system and this all galaxy, this everything are different components. You cannot relate them. They are present in the universe, but they are totally different from each other. And these stars which we can see, their birthplace is nebula. And nebula is that cloud which is made up of mainly hydrogen gas and dust particles. These particles in the clouds are attracted towards one another due to the force of gravity. They are coming close to each other just because of the force of gravity. As a result, the cloud contracts and becomes dense and spherical in shape. At the same time, the pressure of the gas at the core of the cloud increases because causing the temperature to rise tremendously, and energy generation process starts there. Such a spherical cloud of hydrogen is called as star. So here they have given you the process of the birth of a star. Just because of the tremendous pressure and temperature, this hydrogen gas is later getting converted into a star. The birthplace of star is nebula. So later the process of contraction, expansion, rise in the temperature, etc. brings about the changes in the nature of star. So sometimes we can see that, you can see that some of the stars, they are variable. Variable means they, some luminance like brightness increases, decreases. Other stars, they are totally different from each other. Some are binary stars. So these all things are based totally upon these three parts, that is contraction, expansion and rise in the temperature. So there are the different stars. You can see here the picture is given, the life cycle of the star, the nebula, the ordinary star, how it gets converted into different parts, different type of star. So our solar system is a tiny part of the galaxy called the Milky Way. You stay in the solar system and the solar system is a part of the galaxy. Our galaxy name is the Milky Way. We also say it as Mandakini. The neighboring galaxy, you will be already knowing this, it is called to be as the Andromeda. Andromeda is a neighboring galaxy of the Milky Way. So there are lakhs of stars in the Milky Way, some of them being many times bigger than our sun and some are smaller than the sun. You can see that in this solar system, the stars which are present, there are some stars are bigger than sun and some stars might be smaller than sun also. Some of them have their own planetary system. Now you know our solar system. Such a way, others also might have the planetary system. Stars in the Milky Way show the great diversity in the color. Diversity means there is a lot of difference in their color, brightness, etc. And for this part, you can take a certain star in the cloud or you can see during the night time, they are forming a certain shape. So when they come together and they form a certain shape, it is said to be as constellation. So we shall learn more about the constellation in this lesson. Sky watching. Now basically when you are standing in the ground, in the open ground, the point, the exact point above your head in the celestial sphere, means in the upper part, in the sky, is said to be as the zenith. So always remember, the topmost point of your head, you can see up in the sky, that point is said to be as zenith. When you are standing in an open ground. Now there is a word called as horizon. Horizon means what? See, whenever we go far away, we can see that the sky and the land are touching each other. The sky and land, they are touching each other. Or whenever you go and visit the seaside or the coastal areas, you can see the sea level and the sky is being getting touched. Actually, it's not so, but it seems like it is getting touched, and that part or that line is said to be as the horizon. In Marathi, we called it as Kshitij. So, this everything included, which is present, the virtual sphere. The virtual sphere means the actual sphere which is present up above your head, which is real, but actually you cannot touch it. Okay, so that is the celestial sphere. So it is basically divided into two main types. One is zenith and one is nadir. Zenith means the point exactly above your head is there to be at zenith. And when you are standing in an open ground, the point exactly below your feet is called as nadir. So the celestial poles. How you know that there are north pole and south pole? Same, there are celestial north pole and there is celestial south pole. Meridian means what? In astronomy, the great circle which passes through the both the celestial poles and the observer's zenith and nadir is called as meridian. So you can see, basically we say it as equator, but here approximately what they have given you, the sphere, the circle which passes from the celestial north pole and also touches celestial south pole, it is said to be as the meridian. So basically there is a celestial equator also. You can clearly compare it with a normal equator. If we uniformly expand the Earth's equator in all the direction, it will penetrate the celestial sphere along a circle, and the circle which is formed in the between area is said to be as the celestial equator. And what is meant by ecliptic? Ecliptic means what? Sometimes the Earth moves around the Sun, but it's seen from the Earth, you feel that the Sun appears to be moving around the Earth. Actually, we are revolving around the Sun, but when we are present at one place, we feel that the Sun is revolving. And that motion, that apparent motion along which the Sun revolves, which we feel, is said to be as the ecliptic. Actually, this is totally imaginary. Like this, nothing happens because it is our sort of imagination. We revolve around the Sun. Sun never revolve around us. Okay, so for today it is this much. Just go through it and we will see the next part later.